Hello and welcome to Ask Porsche. I'm Alex and this is Andy from Porsche.
Hi.
We're here in the studio in Stuttgart-Zuffenhausen and I will be asking him your questions about this beautiful car, the Taycan, Porsche's first all-electric car.
We accepted the challenge, 800 volt. We are faster with Ionity. Charging is easy. We use state-of-the-art lithium-ion technology.
The rims, the glass roof, the fly line, or the 4-point LED headlights. To me, the Taycan is the sexiest electric car out there. And with me, Porsche expert Andy,
Hi.
Who's here to answer a question about the design process. Hey, so what was the hardest thing to design in this car?
Yeah, there were a lot of hard ones, but I think the biggest innovation was also the biggest challenge. It's about 800 volt.
Yeah.
Because nobody has it. It's a complete novelty. We basically had to start from scratch. So all new, electric motors and the complete new battery.
What are the advantages of this 800 volt architecture? Why did you implement this in this car?
The major benefit is, of course, the charging performance. Yeah, we are best in class with up to 270 kilowatts.
What about the things that I've mentioned?
Yeah, a sporty fly line is always a challenge, especially because we had the objective that you can sit very comfortably in the second row. That's why we implemented that foot garage thing where you can put your feet in. But another one I would like to mention is that we really had to make sure that the car really deserves the name Porsche. We have a long heritage, so we had to make sure that the car has acceleration, track performance, agility and driving dynamics like a Porsche.
Thank you for those insights in the design process and thank you for asking this question. After driving this car, trust me, this is an amazing Porsche sports car. See you in the next video. Ready for another one?
Bring it on.
All right. Is the Taycan compatible with Tesla superchargers?
No, it's not, because Tesla is using its own proprietary standard. That means no manufacturer can use that. We went another direction because we want to be open for third parties. That's why we established a joint venture. It's called Ionity. We teamed up with BMW, Daimler, Ford and the Volkswagen Group, and we plan to establish 400 of these stations in Europe.
I really like the approach that anybody can use it, but how fast are they?
It's super fast. Should I show you how the charging process works? Okay. Basically, you have to open the charge port like that.
No, that is a smooth way to open the charge port.
Right. Then you plug in. Yeah, the charging time is best in class. We just need 22.5 minutes for charging process from 5 to 80%. Or in other words, we just need 5 minutes to get 100 kilometers of range.
That is really fast.
It is.
And what about the United States?
Good point. There we're gonna use the Electrify America network, which is also very fast.
Nice. There you have it. No superchargers, but Ionity is even faster. Great question. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video. Outfreak wants to know, how do you pay at the charging station? Which card do you use?
Yeah, you can use the Taycan charging card over here. It provides you access to more than 100,000 charging stations across Europe and across different providers. For example, on a Ionity station like this. And it's pretty easy because you can identify yourself with a card here on the charge spot, plug in, and then the car is charging. By the way, the cost for a full charge from 0 to 100% is about 30 euros.
Nice. And now look what I found on the phone, the Porsche Connect app. In case you forget the card or you just prefer using your smartphone, you can activate the charging session in the Porsche Connect app. Another feature that is pretty convenient is the bill history. You always see where you charged and how much money it cost. Autofreak, thanks for asking this important question. On to the next one. Felix sent us a techie question about the Taycan, and I have the perfect man to ask it to, our Porsche expert Andy. You're ready for the techie question?
I hope so.
All right. Which battery cell is used in the Taycan?
That's an easy one. We use state-of-the-art lithium-ion technology. It comes from LG.
Felix has an add-on to his question. He wants to know, is it the NMC 811 that Kia is using?
Maybe first of all, we have to explain what that abbreviation stands for.
Yeah.
It stands for nickel manganese cobalt, and it refers to one of the electrodes in a battery, mostly the cathode. I can tell you that we use a NMC-based lithium-ion battery for our car, but it's performance-orientated, so it's not the same.
Okay, and what are the positive properties of that battery technology?
Well, the most important factor for us is performance, because we can charge really fast and we can drive really fast.
OK, Can you talk to me about the structure of the battery?
Yes, of course. Maybe we have a look at the graphic over here. We see a lot of the technology. I can show you, for example, the battery modules. 33 modules are on board. You can see these blocks over there. Each module comes with 12 pouch cells. In total, we have around 400 pouch cells.
Okay, I don't want to do the math. I just trust you on that. But what is this gap here? Why is there a gap?
Here we left some space for your feet. When you're sitting in the second row, the so-called foot garage helps you to sit more comfortable. And by the way, it helps us to stick to our sporty fly line.
Guys, thank you for your interest. We hope you enjoyed this. Goodbye for now from Stuttgart-Zuffenhausen.